I will just make a brief introduction to what we have in Brazil. Then we started to do research in carbon nanotubes about 12 years ago. In the beginning, it was Professor Luiz Ladeira doing production and some applications of nanotubes, and I was doing optical properties of nanotubes. But now we have a very strong group of people working in nanotubes, and we have, first we have the so-called Brazilian network on nanotube research. I will show you that. Then it's in the five last years we have this network of nanotube research. And in the last year we had also the National Institute of Science and Technology of Carbon Nanomaterials. Then I will give you an overview. Okay, there's the idea, this is first the Brazilian network of carbon nanotube. We have, we start in 2006. In fact, it lasts until this year, 2010. We have 40 main investigators, and in this network we have mainly physicists and chemists. We have 17 centers in 13 institutions in 8 states of Brazil. I will show you the distribution. And the idea of this network was first, it was very important for us in Brazil to do the production of nanotubes. Also, the second part, some fundamental studies and characterization. And the third was some applications and devices, and my colleagues, they will give an overview of some things that we're doing. This is the map of Brazil. Then here is the state of Minas Gerais. We are coordinating here the network, but you can see that we have people working nanotubes in many different parts of Brazil, and from the north of Brazil, and also this northeastern part of Brazil. And groups, many groups here in the state of Minas Gerais, also Rio de Janeiro, people doing theory, São Paulo state, Paraná, and Rio Grande do Sul. Okay, then that's to show you that then we organize every year workshops of the carbon nanotube network. It starts in the 2006, where we had 110 participants and 70 presentations about nanotubes. We had here in 2007 the conference Nanotube 07 with 400 participants, but 130 participants from Brazil, and with 85 works presented. And every year now we have a workshop. Last year the workshop was in Niterói near Rio de Janeiro with 117 participants and 115 presentations about nanotubes. And we will have now in November at the meeting in Fortaleza, we have 180 participants presenting works in nanotubes and now alpha graphene. Okay, then last year we had this the National Institute of Science and Technology of Carbon Nanomaterials that is also headed here in this university. But we have now 55 main investigators from 20 centers in Brazil, and now we also have some companies that are also with us. And the idea of this institute is that we have now carbon nanotubes and also graphene. And in the field of carbon nanotubes, what we have now, we have more biologists included in this institute. People doing production, characterization, applications, and also some toxicology studies of carbon nanotubes. And now we have also the people doing graphene production and characterization of graphene. Our recent progress in carbon nanostructure research in Brazil. We also have some groups doing synthesis of nanotubes, people doing purification, dispersion, and functionalization of nanotubes, chemistry. We have now progressed towards large-scale production of nanotubes. We have many people here working with nanocomposites and nanotubes and polymers and other kind of thing for energy storage, fuel cells, supercapacitors, photovoltaic device, and also aerospatial coating with the aerospatial agency in Brazil. We have here people doing also gas sensors and biosensors using nanotube, and also some biomedical applications, tissue regeneration and genic transfection. And from the field of graphene, we are now we can now produce graphene by many different methods. People, we are doing mechanical exfoliation, chemical exfoliation, CVD, and graphene from silicon carbide. And also we have here in our group some very strong people doing theory, modelization. Then we have fundamental studies and some significant contributions for the basic sciences of nanotubes and graphene. Okay, then I will just show you people that the program of this conference. Then I will start with Professor Luis Ladeira. He will talk about the production of nanotubes and some applications. The second one is Professor Ladeira is here from UFMG, Physics Department of UFMG. Rogério Paniago, also from the Physics Department of UFMG. He will talk about synthesis and characterization of epitaxial graphene. After that, we have also from UFMG, Bernardo Neves, talking about some mechanical properties of nanotubes and some AFM studies. Ricardo Nunes will talk about that we have a very good group here of theory, first principle studies of nanocarbons. Then Ricardo will talk about that. And we have Adelina Santos and Placidia Furtado. They are from the Center of Nuclear Technology. They will talk about chemistry of nanotubes. We have Gustavo Cansado, that's from the Physics Department. He will talk about Raman spectroscopy studies in nanotubes and also graphene here. After that, we have Juliana Branch. She's finishing the PhD. She will show you some results on transport measurements in graphene devices. And at the end, we have Glaura Silva. She's from the Chemistry Department. And she will talk about chemistry of nanotubes and also some composite with nanotubes. And just before finishing, I will talk about the next step for us is that I think that we worked in this 12 last years doing basic research and some application at the level of academia and university. And our next step is now to make a center of technology in nanotubes that we call CT nanotubes. Then the idea is that this center will be installed here in the technological park of UFMG and the Minas Gerais government. And that's the idea of the Center of Technology in Nanotube. You have the center, we have some breaks, large-scale production of nanotubes, a composite with cement, composite with some polymers, and this is we have some demand from the oil company Petrobras. They need some applications. And we work with the issue of safety and effects on the environment and things like that. And also we work in different kind of research involving nanotubes. Then hopefully this will have a support from the oil company and we'll start next year this center. Okay, thank you. And probably we can go with Ladeira.